And joining me now is Ohio Congressman Mike Turner, a Republican who sees this situation much differently. And sir, thank you so much for coming on. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me, Rob. Well, Rob, I think you certainly have made an excellent point that it didn't have to be this way. Okay. President Biden has not lived up to the promise that he made, that we would leave Afghanistan in not only an honorable way, but in a way that leaves the country secure. This looks more like a surrender than a withdrawal. Mm. You have two presidents, President Trump and Biden, both indicating that they have the goal of ending of the United States involvement. But Trump's goals were very, very different than President Biden. President Biden's goals are just get out. President Trump's goals were actually to negotiate with the Taliban and try to secure a workable transition from the United States presence for Afghanistan and not merely hand over Bagram, our guns, our weapons to the Taliban. What we're seeing here really is just a total travesty.
Understood. As far as just the overarching theme of this, though, leaving Afghanistan versus staying, are you in opposition to pulling out?
Well, I think that it's how we pull out, Rob. I mean, I think that your statements were really somewhat oversimplistic as to what's been happening with Afghanistan. As you know, the United States was attacked on 9/11. We went in not just merely bring justice to al-Qaeda, but also the country itself was harboring terrorists and terrorism. What we needed to do was to secure the country. What happened from then till now has been an attempt, as you know, to try to secure peace. The Taliban, though, has never been a peaceful group and organization. Even the areas of the country that they control are not peaceful. No. This is not as if you can have a transition to Taliban control that's even going to result in any peace for Afghanistan itself. Certainly, George Bush's goals were noble, but we're well past that. We're to a point where we need to secure any threat to the United States. We need to be able to do a counterterrorism effort in Afghanistan as those might arise. But what we're seeing here from the Biden administration is complete surrender. You don't have a U.S. withdrawal and immediately have the Taliban have pictures of our weapons and places where we were, as opposed to the Afghans having control of this territory. This really is a travesty.
Understood. But it seems like what you want to secure the country, prevent it from being a harbor for terror, prevent it from being an extremist nation. To me, all of that sounds like something that we have to go in and never, ever leave. And I just think
your entrance was incredibly simplistic because if you have to look, and I've been to Afghanistan several times, in fact, just pre-COVID, meeting with our commanders there and their assessments and attempting to try, while the Trump administration was negotiating to try to get a resolution with the Taliban, attempting to try to ensure that the Afghan people are safe and that there be a transition that could also have the United States safe. Remember, our NATO allies weren't just there because the United States asked them to be. Their independent assessment also was Afghanistan remained a risk to the West and the United States. What we see now with what the Biden administration has done is not what the Trump administration was trying to accomplish. I think the Trump administration's goals had broad support in Congress. This is not just an issue of, like, you know, punching your library card and make certain you're there or you're not there.
It's
the country so it's not a threat to the United States.
How do you do that? I mean, after 20 years securing
this
place, how do you get to that point?
I mean, Rob, unless you think what President Biden is doing, I mean, it's correct. I can't imagine you defend what President Biden's doing. President Trump was actually with Secretary of State Pompeo looking for a way to both secure the country and to exit. Biden said we're not going to run for the exits, but he's clearly running for the exits.
Do you think that Pompeo and Trump were ever going to get there? I mean, I get what they were trying to do. I understand
the
goal.
I do, and I supported what they were doing. They certainly, I do not think in any instance President Trump would have left Bagram in the middle of the night and left it for the Taliban to ransack and to have the Afghan National Army being left even unaware or able to defend the equipment that's left behind.
I think we both agree.
What President Trump was doing, but I don't know that you do. I think it seems like you're saying that what President Biden did is right, and this is not right.
No, I'm not saying. I think we both agree that Biden's probably making some mistakes in the pullout here. What I don't agree with is this idea that we were so close to magically turning this country into a safe, functional nation that won't harbor terrorism. When in my mind, I feel like I don't care if you leave in 2080. That place is going to devolve super fast. So I think you have two choices. You stay forever or you just pull the plug.
Well, Rob, I'm not going to debate what's in your mind, but I am going to debate with you the difference between the President Trump and President Biden.
Okay.
And what President Trump was doing, you would not have seen what is happening today. And this is both a travesty for the Afghanis, a travesty for the investment that the United States and NATO has made, and it makes our country less safe. President Trump and Secretary of State Pompeo, what they are attempting to achieve, would have given us both the ability to leave the country and at the same time keep America safe.
Let me ask you this, just one final question. You have full power over this situation. We put you in charge, you're the man on Afghanistan. What do you do over, and we'll give you five more years. What do you do to turn Afghanistan into a safe, functional place?
I don't want five more years. Again, I don't know who you're debating here, but no. I don't want five more years. I wanted, which is why I voted for President Trump, President Trump and Pompeo, to continue their efforts to both secure the country, support the Afghan national military, and have a withdrawal that also included a way to be able to support the United States' interests and to keep America safe, not this leaving for the exits. Biden promises, you just played the clip, he said, we are not going to be running for the exits. They ran for the exits in the middle of the night. This is a surrender, not a withdrawal, and this is not what President Trump would have done, and that certainly is what I supported.
I think you make
you're
a fair...
have to find someone else to debate on whether or not anybody wants to just
listen,
hang out.
I'm not trying to put you in a, you know, in a debacle or in a pickle here. I'm just saying, and you know, I just don't see how, even with Trump and Pompeo at the helm, I don't see how you walk out of that place and it just stays secure for any period of time. I just can't see it. But anyway, we agree on some things. We might disagree on others, but we do appreciate the debate here, sir. Thank you so much.
Rob, I appreciate you having me. Thank you so much.
Of course. Ohio Congressman Mike Turner, thanks for the time.